Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetjuice.com and today we are going to do the quick unboxing and quick overview of a new phone which we have got from Micromax. This one is called Canvas Selfie 2, which is an upgrade over the previous Canvas Selfie which we have seen. This one has got 5 megapixel camera at the back as well as at the front, and we have the specification for the device mentioned at the back side of the box, which includes a 1.3 GHz quad-core CPU, which is an old hardware, and it looks like it is MediaTek 6582. We will confirm that. We have 3G supported on this phone. We have 5 inch of FWVGA display, so it is again having an IPS LCD panel, but the display is not HD, it is FWVGA. We will show you how does that look like. We have 1 GB of RAM, 8 GB of internal memory. We have 5 megapixel autofocus camera at the back, and the front camera is 5 megapixel but it is fixed focus camera. We have these frequency bands which are supported, so 3G is supported on this one but 4G is not supported. We have support for recording video. Again, whether we can record high definition video, we will just confirm that. We should be able to do that, but not at 30 fps as per the information which we have got. We have got Android Lollipop 5.0 on this one. We do have support for assisted GPS as well, and the battery inside is 2000 mAh. So this is again another phone from Micromax in the market, especially to target people who are living in tier 2 and tier 3. This one has decent specification, and the price point at which it comes is approximately 5000 rupees or maybe slightly less. The MRP which is mentioned in the package is 6499, as you can see over there, and again it will be available in the market for a price of approximately 5000 rupees. So here we have the phone, and this is how it looks like. We have already opened the box and we have inserted the battery inside. This is how the phone looked like from the back side. One thing which I really like is the back cover. The back cover finishing gives you fake leather kind of feel, which gives you a very nice grip, and it is matte finish, so it won't get the fingerprints and scratches very easily. We have got the Micromax logo over there, which looks nice, and it is finished in chrome. We have 5 megapixel autofocus camera at the back, LED flash over there. We have a circular power button over there, which is giving you good amount of feedback. And here you have the plastic volume rocker, which is again okay. It gives you good amount of feedback and it also produces a sound. We have a little indent to remove the back cover over there. Here we have the loudspeaker, which will get blocked and muffled when you place the device flat on the table when you are watching a video. Over there on the top, on the front, we have got a nice metallic earpiece. The front camera is there in the center so that you can position yourself properly while taking your selfies. And here we have touch capacitive buttons which are there on the body of the phone, and they do not have any backlit LED. The UI which is there on this device is a custom UI, and again there is a lot of bloatware as well which is coming pre-installed on this device, and we will show you how you can actually uninstall that bloatware and reclaim the storage on this device. So in terms of storage, it has got 8 GB of internal storage, out of which how much is available we will just show you. Let me just remove the back cover and show you the phone from the back side before we take a look over the box contents. And here we have the phone from the back side. Here we have a micro SD memory card slot so that you can expand the storage, and you can install applications from the SD card as well. We have the SIM card slot 2, SIM card slot 1. Both of them will accept micro SIM, and both of them support 3G as well. We have the battery, which is 2000 mAh battery, and the SAR values are also mentioned over there on this device, which is 0.36 watt per kg for 1 gram head, and it is 0.66 watt per kg for 1 gram body. So let me put the phone battery inside and we will take a look over the box contents now. And here we have the box. I would like to open this box and show you what you get inside. Let me give you a closer look over the package contents. So here we have the box. The thing which we have got after the device is this charger, and this charger in terms of the output current is 1 ampere charger. So you're getting a 1 ampere charger, standard headphones. Again, these are very standard ones, and the build quality is just average on these ones. These are plastic headphones, and the sound quality is again also kind of average. We have the micro USB cable which can be used for data syncing and charging. This is USB 2.0, in case you want to know that. We have a pamphlet over there, some advertisement pamphlet as well. They always give you this Canvas tab booklet inside the phone package content so that you can actually get to know about their tablets, which actually are okay if not great. We have SAR values mentioned over here as well, which are the same which we have already told you. We have this warranty card and a quick start guide. The model number of this device is Q340, in case you want to know that. You are also getting a screen guard within the package, as you can see. Apart from all these things, you're also getting a screen guard which comes within the package, and you have a tool and a cleaning cloth as well. So these are all the package contents. I would like to put everything inside the package again, and we will take a closer look over the Micromax Canvas Selfie 2, which looks like a good phone to me, and I would like to test the camera in detail. I will do a quick camera test as well in this video so that you can find out how good the camera is, especially when you want to take selfies of yours in low light scenario. We will just do that. Let me just power on the device and then give you a physical overview. Here we have the Canvas Selfie 2 up and close, and one thing which I really like is the build quality of the phone. So build quality for the price is pretty good on this one. Talking about the connectivity, we have got micro USB port for data syncing and charging at the bottom. We also have got the prime microphone. As far as headphone jack is concerned, it is there at the top, which you can see. It is a 3.5mm headphone jack. Let's take a look of the software UI, about which we have already given you a kind of a view what we feel. So again, software UI is smooth and responsive, at least as of now. Let's take a look over the settings and find out what all we have as far as version of Android is concerned. So again, settings UI is stock Android, which is good, and we have Android 5.0 on this device. Let's take a look over the storage and find out how much of storage we have. So we have 8 GB of internal storage. Out of that, 3.95 GB is available to the user. So again, you have approximately 4 GB available on this device. You do have support for changing the default right disk. That means you can insert an SD card and install application on that as well. When it comes to the applications which are coming as bloatware, there are around 700 MB of application which are coming as bloatware. And let me take a look over these applications. For example, Amazon Kindle, not Google Play services. Let me just come back. Amazon Kindle application is actually a bloatware for me, and even especially if I don't use it, then I can disable it, but I cannot uninstall it. But let me see if there are other applications which are kind of bloatware, whether I can remove that. So Hotstar application can be removed, which is good. And then if we take a look over some other applications, I think NewsHunt. So maybe, yeah, I can uninstall NewsHunt as well. So most of the applications which are coming pre-installed on this device, you can uninstall them, which is good, or you can disable them in case you cannot uninstall. Let's take a look over the application scenario and find out the current status of the RAM. And again, as you can see, we have got the RAM status over there. Yeah, it is loaded and it has got 1 GB of RAM. Out of that, 500 MB of RAM is free. So half of the 1 GB of RAM you are getting on this device, or when you take it out of the box. This is how the RAM scenario is. Let's take a look over the display settings, and we have support for adaptive brightness as well, which is also good. So overall, the device is responsive and smooth till now. There is no issue, and the UI is also working fine. Let's take a look over the UI, the kind of UI it has. We would like to show you that. So we have this kind of a UI, which is home screen, which allows you to launch messaging application quickly from here, contacts application. You can go to phone dialer, you can launch camera, and you can actually go to this application bazaar, which I don't like. And you can always get rid of this one as well in case you don't want to basically use it, but it will give you access to certain applications which are being promoted through this phone. If we take a look over the other interface which we have the option to control the music and settings. So everything is there on the direct home screen with the time so that you can access it quickly. And I would like to go to messaging application and find out the experience we have on the keyboard. And okay, yeah, now it is working. So it is the first touch messaging application. It is again kind of custom one, and the keyboard is also custom. Let me try typing. So typing experience is good. It does not give you a vibration haptic feedback, so there is no vibration feedback whenever you type. And the keyboard keys does give you a pop-up, and the keyboard is pretty easy to type. I do not see any issue, but there is no option of doing swipe to type on this device. And again, you can enable this feature with the help of third-party keyboards. Let's take a look over some applications like music, and we would like to find out how good the music quality is. And I think we do not have any music files on this one, so we will rather play a YouTube video in this case. One thing I would like to tell you, typing on this keyboard which we have on this phone is kind of difficult. You cannot type very fast because again, it does not give you that fast typing response from the keyboard, which might create some problem for some people out there, especially in case who would like to type faster on this phone. It is slightly difficult because of the custom keyboard which is there. Again, you can type fast with the help of the stock Android keyboard, but with this keyboard you cannot type fast.
Hi, my name is Fish.
Let me just skip this. Yeah, So here we have the video playing, and in terms of viewing angles, I would say viewing angles are good, if not great. I can see the display, which is more important. The colors may not look that good, but the overall display visibility is good enough. Let's take a look over the sound quality, and we will increase the volume to full. So the volume is full right now, and the device is fairly loud. For a device like this, which is available at an affordable price point, it is good enough. But if you place it on the table like this, the sound is blocked completely. So it is completely muffled and blocked because the loudspeaker is there at the back side. So either you hold it in the right way or you keep it like this all the time. If you place it on the table, the sound will be muffled. But overall, the loudspeaker is fairly loud. Let's take the camera, and we have the camera interface loaded already. Let me just focus on this subject. It does have tap to focus, and the camera shutter is quick but not very fast. Let me take a front camera selfie as well. You do have support for HDR as well on this device, which is possible. You can take photos in HDR mode as well. So we have just taken the selfie from the front camera, and I would like to show you how good the selfie is. This is how it looks like. Again, in terms of the details, it has captured details not so nicely. The display is also kind of reflective, and in sunlight, the visibility of this display is again not great, but details are nicely captured, I would say, if it is not very clear. The 5-megapixel camera on this device is working nicely, but again, I was expecting better results, actually better than this, than what we have actually got. In terms of color production, it is good, if it is not too great. Let's take a look over the rear camera quality. So rear camera quality is actually good because it has done the focus very nicely. Details are also captured very nicely on this device. As you can see, everything is crisp and clear, and the color production is also done in a good way. So I can see this photo, which is looking better than the front camera photo, which is still looking good again for a low light shot, but this could have been better if they have given a autofocus camera at the front. So all in all, this is a budget device, I would say, for selfie lovers. In case you don't want to spend much of the money on this phone and you want good selfie cameras at the front as well as at the back side, you can go for this one. So this is all we have as far as the quick unboxing and quick overview of the Canvas Selfie 2. In case you have any questions and queries for this device, you can leave your questions and queries in the comment section below. You can like this video if this video helped you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.